Good day to you. I'm Jenna Carter Simmers, and this is What's on Your iPod. Each Thursday, I only want to know one thing. What music are you listening to? And I'll do some sharing as well. Our guest today is saxophonist Lakecia Benjamin. She's one half of the Female Face-Off, taking place tonight during the 5th Annual Battle of the Saxes at Rose E. McCoy Auditorium on the campus of Jackson State. The concert also features Chelsea Barrett and Marcus Anderson. If you want to know what Lakecia Benjamin is listening to, you'll have to stay tuned. We'll be right back.
The WJSU Battle of the Saxes is back for its 5th consecutive year, Thursday, December 10th, 7 p.m. at the Rose E. McCoy Auditorium. This year's battle is a female face-off between Lakecia Benjamin and Chelsea Barrett. Famed trumpeter Nicholas Payton is our special musical guest, and the 2009 Capital Jazz Fest competition winner, Marcus Anderson, is our headliner. Pre-order your tickets today by calling 601-979-2285. The 5th Annual Battle of the Saxes, Thursday, December 10th, 7 p.m. at the Rose E. McCoy Auditorium.
I'm Jenna Carter Simmers. Welcome back to What's on Your iPod. For the first time in the history of the Battle of the Saxes, two young ladies will share the stage. Live in the studio is one of those young ladies, Lakecia Benjamin. Lakecia Benjamin, welcome to Jackson, Mississippi.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good. Lakecia, did you choose the saxophone or did it choose you?
I would have to say I started at a pretty young age, around 11 years old, but it definitely was the saxophone chose me.
Mm-hmm.
It was like I had a choice between band, art, or chorus.
Okay.
So I naturally, somehow, something inside of me was like, I'm going to pick band. And then the teacher came up to me and he said, well, which instrument do you want to play? And I said, the saxophone. And he said, well, we're out of saxophones, young lady, but you want to play the bass? I said, no, sir. Then he said, how about the drums? He showed me all the stuff. I said, well, you know what? I'll come back next year.
Mm-hmm.
When you have a saxophone. So I waited, and next year I came back.
You held out for that one love, that saxophone.
Yeah.
One of the things I'm really proud of about this year's Battle of the Sax is that each participant, you, Lakecia, Chelsea, and Marcus, you all are just 23 years old, but you guys play beyond your years. I'm really happy because for me it means that jazz is attracting younger folks. So that means the longevity of this genre is guaranteed. What's so special about jazz in your mind, Lakecia?
The thing, I feel like when I was young, I went to LaGuardia High School in New York City. It's a music and art school. And they have a pretty extensive jazz program run by Bob Stewart. He plays with brass band. You see a lot of, you know, popular jazz people. But the thing about jazz, I feel that it's when you talk to somebody, it's taught more so that this is an emotion and expression.
Okay.
And a feeling from a different, you know, from a people and a group, you know, an African-American experience. So it's not necessarily that this certain age group went through this. This is something that your forefathers went through. And this is something that can be expressed by anyone. So as long as you have something to express and say and something to do with the history and dealt with the experience you're feeling, you know, anybody can be a part of this music or any music that comes from that.
Okay, well said. What music are you listening to? Is there something special that inspires you?
Well, actually, on my iPod coming over here on the flight, first thing I was listening to Stevie Wonder, Creepin'.
Mm-hmm.
That's one of my favorite cuts. And then I kind of segued because I was looking for a more up-paced, like, tempo thing. And I listened to Sonny Stitt with the Oscar Peterson Trio, a track called Au Revoir.
All right.
This is a Charlie Parker selection.
All right. Well, we'll have to add those selections to our iPods. Lakecia just happens to have a saxophone handy. How about you playing a little something for us, Lakecia?
Sure.
Deserves a round of applause. Beautiful. Who was that tuned by?
It was actually The Closer I Get to You.
Okay.
And maybe, I think one of the people that made it famous was Donny Hathaway and Roberta Flack.
Mm-hmm.
So I did a little intro in the beginning and, you know, segued into it.
And you made it your own. I wonder, how hard has it been for you to be taken seriously as a saxophonist? Do you think that being a female saxophonist has made it difficult, or do you think it's opened some doors for you?
I think probably for any female in a male-dominated, you know, field, maybe a little bit of both. But I would say for the most part, it's almost like the music had me in a trance. In the beginning, I never really noticed that I was the only woman at the clubs late at night.
Really?
No, it never even dawned on me. Then I think one day someone called me and asked me to do a show featuring an all-female band. And then it was kind of like a little light bulb, like, whoo, like, oh, yeah, okay.
I am a girl.
Yeah, it is. Like, you know, and because when you're surrounded by men so much and trying to practice and just learn and grow in your craft, it's like almost like a spiritual thing. You kind of forget so much, like, all the genders involved. You know, then puberty and all that happens, and then you start to realize, oh, yes, boy-girl thing. But as far as opening doors, I would say it's opened some and it's closed some, because in this industry, we know music is like, you know, it's an emotional thing. It's great. It's something we all love, but it also is a business.
Okay.
So in certain people's business, you know, if someone's looking for an artist, it's all about some look that comes with that artist. So mm-hmm. if your band is, you're looking for a heavy metal, rock, hardcore, like, you might not want a female in the band depending upon what you're trying to push out. But for the most part, I think regardless of your gender, if you remain positive and, you know, strive and learn your craft and really just, you know, be a presentable person and keep your spirits high, doesn't really matter either way.
Why do you think so few women are attracted to the saxophone?
Maybe it's just a voicing thing, you know. I can't really say. I always have wondered that, you know, why a lot of women play the violin or the flute.
And the piano.
The piano or something. I think it probably has something to do with general study throughout history. Like, women were taught to play classical piano, classical violin, you know. In the classical fields, those instruments are acceptable, the flute. But the saxophone, except unless you're playing French Revolution, it's not really in the classical world. So mm-hmm. it might not be so much acceptable.
I tell you what, we have time for one more song. Will you play something else for us?
Sure.
That was Lakecia Benjamin. And the name of that selection, Lakecia?
That was actually Lester Leapson.
All right. Thank you so much. Lakecia, you've been a great guest. You have me so excited about tonight's performance, the 5th Annual Battle of the Saxes, 7 p.m. at the Rose E. McCoy Auditorium. The ticket office opens at 6 p.m. and doors open at 6:30. It's a female face-off, also featuring Chelsea Barrett, and Marcus Anderson is our headliner. And oh, by the way, Grammy Award-winning trumpeter Nicholas Payton will also grace us. Next, how about we end with a Lakecia Benjamin original? It's titled Maceo. We'll talk next week.